Y'all are probably wondering, you turn it down. Y'all are probably wondering why I didn't get up here and sing. Whenever I was little, I used to really love to sing, but then once I hit puberty in my voice, you know, voice changes a little bit. I didn't really like that. So, just want to thank everybody for coming out again. You know, it was great. Last night, I thought we had a great service. And first off, I want to talk about the music. You know, Wesley done great singing, and as a young person, as I'm going through school and stuff, music influences the young people like crazy. The kind of music that you listen to, it really defines the person that you are. I see kids walking down the hallway, you probably see them play with headphones, and you're walking from class to class, first period, second period, you have like 5 minutes, and you can put headphones in, and they listen to some awful music, and that's the kind of person that defines them. They're awful. And not to be talking about them, but if they would influence their bodies with different things, you know, it might help them a little bit. So that I thought Wesley was great. You know, I have a couple songs on my phone that God's Not Dead that was in the movie, and that's one of my favorite songs. It's great, and it makes me feel better about myself whenever I'm listening to it instead of nasty rap music and all kinds of stuff. So the title of my message is "Are You Hungry?" So, I want to tell you about how I got my message. This Sunday that just passed, you know, me and Terry called me and he wanted me to preach, and I'm thinking about different things. I woke up Sunday morning, like I told you all last night. I wake up every morning, read my Bible, and then before I go to bed, I read my Bible. So, before church on Sunday morning, I had just finished the Old Testament in my Bible, and I'm working on the New Testament. First book in the New Testament is Matthew. So, I'm in Matthew. I wake up, read my Bible. And I'm going Matthew chapter 5. And I read that. And then I go to church. And my Sunday school teacher, her lesson for the kids that's there is Matthew chapter 5. And I was like, wow, you know, this is awesome. And I want you all here too. So, if you will, you'll turn your Bibles to Matthew chapter 5, verse 6. Chapter 5, verse 6. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you for another opportunity to be in your house. I thank you for every person that's here. I just ask that you let them receive this message, and I thank you for all things. Amen. So, I first want to ask you all, starting out, what is righteousness? So, I went to Webster's Dictionary. Doing or according to, which is right, yielding to all wrong, free from guilt or sin. Every person in here has a conscience, that little small, still voice inside you, back of your head. And you know if you do something wrong. It's called guilt, whenever you feel that. Whenever you're feeling this guilt, you've got to get rid of it somehow. Best way to get rid of guilt is first pray and ask forgiveness for whatever you did. If you said something to somebody, if I said something bad to Kobe, I need to go to Kobe, and I need to say I'm sorry for whatever I did. Then you also got to ask God for the wrongdoing, or to forgive you of the wrongdoing that you've done. And that's how you get rid of guilt. And that's how you know if you did something wrong, you have guilt. And if you keep your guilt away, you're going to stay away from sin. So, another thing is, I'm going to say, who in here, whenever you get hungry, you get impatient. You want your food now. You don't want to wait in lines at no restaurants. You don't want to wait for mom to get done cooking it on the stove. You want to walk in the house and say, Mom, where's my food? So, that's the thing. We should be the same way with God. See, God blesses us every day, and we should want those blessings like that. For God to bless us like that, we have to stay in righteousness. We have to be righteous. We have to stay away from sin. We have to stay away from guilt. And God will bless us. Psalms 106:3. Blessed are they who do righteousness at all times. See, whenever you do right, God's going to bless you through your life. If you're helping people, whenever you do right down here, you lay up treasures in heaven. So you want to do righteousness, stay right, and yield from the guilt and yield from the sin. So whenever you're going through life, you're not doing people wrong, because people's going to hold that against you one way or another. See, every day, every Friday, morning, so I go to bed, and he has devotion, and one of our coaches picks a Bible verse, and kind of like gives us a little lesson before the band up, and it's called devotion. You have to be there at like 7:35, but it's not a real long lesson, and you know, yeah, I think it gives us strength on Fridays, because you go to war every Friday, and the main thing all through the season, from the beginning, from July until December, every day you're probably going to hear, do the right thing. At school, you're going to come up against people being bullied, you're going to see people doing wrong stuff, and you need to do the right thing. Sometimes getting bullied, you need to stop it, step in, say, hey, this ain't right, you need to stop doing this. And, you know, that goes a long way, because like I said, people's going to remember you and your legacy. And whenever people think of you, you don't want them thinking of you bad. You don't want to have a bad reputation. As Christians, you need to be thought of good. You need to be the high standard. We're up here, and you know, people look up to you as a Christian, but they also watch every single move. If you're doing wrong things, they're going to think, well, if I'm trying to be a Christian, but if they can do this wrong thing, then I can do that wrong thing. But they're going to look at you as like a scale. And so you always want to maintain a good scale. And he never said, whenever being a Christian, he never said it was going to be easy. It's going to be rough. You're going to come through things in your life, but I promise you, it will be worth it. The rewards that you're going to get in heaven is going to be so much better than these rewards down here in this earthly life. Getting high, that's nothing compared to what you're going to see in heaven. Chewing, getting a little thing in your mouth, that's nothing. So, like I said, you want to stay away from sin, and you want to keep in the righteous. You want to do the right thing every day, and you want to be a light for the Lord, because I know it's not easy going to school and different things, and people always nag and ask you and say different things to you. It's not right, and I know it's not right, but you have to do it. You have to go to school. That's a law. You got to associate people with people in sports and different things, but you have to be a light to them. You have to do the right thing. Be righteous, and that's the main thing I want you all to get from this lesson. And it's, you got to hunger and you got to thirst for righteousness. Whenever you hunger and thirst for it, you will be filled. If you're trying to do the right thing, God will take care of it. If you give your 100% to God, and you're putting all you have out there, then He's going to take care of it. He's going to lift you up and take care of the problem. He's going to help you whatever problem, if you're having a problem with math, or if you have a problem with somebody picking on you, He's going to take care of it. So, stay righteous. You know, Hell is real, and there ain't a lot of righteous people down there. So, that's not somewhere that I want to go. And you got, every day, you got to wake up and you got to say, hey, I'm a Christian, and I know that things are going to come against me that day. You're going to have, like I always said yesterday, with Pastor Payne, you're going to have goblins attacking you. You're going to have little archers attacking you. But you have to stay righteous and do the right thing. And with your faith, you can protect and you can defend your salvation, like I said last night. And being righteous, it goes a long way, and it helps you. And like I said, you're going to be remembered. And people will think, what kind of person was Kobe? What kind of person was Brad? What kind of person was Wesley? And, you know, that legacy and being remembered is awesome. Like we have our little, you have the wall of fame. And you look up there and you see that person every day. And you want to remember for different things, like touchdowns, different games, different things like that. But how do you want to be remembered? What is your legacy? Do you want people to say, well, Wesley Chu, Wesley Pink on people. No, you don't want that. And I know I try every day. I fail every day, but it's the main thing. You got to give 100%. You got to give it all out there. You can't go halfway. You can't straddle the fence. And so you can't be on one side, or you can't be on the middle of the fence trying to be a Christian and then going over here and doing things like this. So stay righteous. You know, it's real easy to go along with the crowd. Somebody's doing something, you want to be cool. You want to be popular. You don't want people to make fun of you. I know. Bad news. You don't want to be picked on. You don't want people saying different things to you. But to be a Christian, you have to say, hey, I'm not going along with the crowd. I'm not going to let you pick on this little girl who doesn't have a whole lot. You're not going to do that. You have to stay righteous and do the right thing. I hear that. That's every day. Whenever we go into practice, do the right thing. Do the right thing. They have signs up on the wall. Do the right thing. Do the right thing. You know, it's right. Do the right thing. And I know it gets annoying, but just do the right thing. Because once Whenever I go to heaven, whenever I die, I want to look at God and say, enter in. You done the right thing. I don't want to hear, get away from me, you work your iniquity. I don't want to hear that. I want to be able to walk through those gates and see the golden streets and see everybody that made it before me. Like I said, every day, do the right thing, but every day you want to seek His face and receive your blessings. How do you do this? Praying, reading your Bible, studying, that's how you seek God's face. And whenever you're doing that, you're staying righteous. Whenever you're reading your Bible, that's what God wants you to do. That's the right way. That's the right thing to do. Whenever you're walking in the hallway and somebody's doing something, you say, hey, that ain't right. That's being righteous. That's doing the right thing. So, I just wanted you all to stay hungry, and thirst for God, and seek His face, and give your 100%. I know it's rough. I know it's tough. And you're, like I said, it's not going to be easy, but you have to get, I promise it'll be worth it. So, this time, if everybody would bow their heads. I know there's some people here that was here yesterday, or maybe some people that wasn't. But that's between them and God. But there was some people that raised their hands last night. And like I said, I don't like putting people on the spot. But hell is real, okay? That it's awful. I'm sure every person here knows about hell. And I don't want anyone in here to go. So we're not promised tomorrow. We're not promised 5 minutes from now. God gave us this moment right here. And like I said, I don't want to put you in the spot. But if there's any person in here that has never gave their life to the Lord, or took a step back, I want you to please come up here or talk to me. You don't have to do it right now. You can talk to me after. But I would feel awful if someone was in here had a chance and didn't get to give their life to the Lord. It would, we could leave right now, put on the road, and car crash, and things like that. I don't want anybody to have to do that. God is so great. He helps me every single day. So, like I said, you all don't have to do it right now. You can go down to church. You can text me, call me after this. But I love every person in here. It means the world to me, you all, okay? And it means the world to me that Terry has gave me this opportunity. So, I thank every person in here. If anyone who would like to give their life to the Lord, if you have a problem, if you're feeling sick, if you're going through a hard time with your life, if you're God's dealing with your heart right now. Like I said earlier, you hear that small, still voice in the back of your head saying, go, go, go. Don't fight it, because you're not promised tomorrow. And so, if there's any person in here, I'm right here. Brother Dalton's right here. I thank you guys.
Stay right there. Okay, guys. I just want to say, just like last night, and I look over here and I think your parents has done a phenomenal job. I mean, you've done it. He's a testimony to you and your wife. Sean, you and Kelly, you're a testimony to the West. I mean, just to get up and to do what he's done. I know Kobe's parents, and I know they're good people, and I know Heath and Jesse and Bridget, how important. Here's what I want us as parents to give, okay? These guys, they need an opportunity to show people that a teenager can be a Christian. And I don't know about you guys, and I told Andrew this, and I think I may even told Bruce this, but I don't know, it's been some time back when we was at Knox County and playing ball up there together. Andrew, your mom had told us, Kobe, that Andrew had gotten saved and gotten called to preach and was preaching. And Brad looked at me and said, Dad, I was beginning to think there wasn't nobody else Christians. I know he knows Wes and Keith and Kobe, those guys. But really willing to step up and say, hey, I'm a Christian. So here's what I'm going to do. And it's a non-denominational thing. I don't care. I'm going to try at least once a month or maybe even twice a month. I've got a big old lot out here. I'm going to do a bonfire out here for you guys. Guys, just invite people to come out and just they can play ball. We'll do hot dogs and stuff. and then sing around the fire, you know, and do stuff like that, and then let Andrew do a devotion. You know, it don't have to be a lot. Their memories, they're short term. They don't want you to preach for an hour. I can get up here and preach for an hour. You know, it was like 5 minutes. They done lost. And he's about to go to sleep. Listen, hey, brother, I have to go sleep on me all the time, let me tell you. There's snoring going on. It's true. But here's, I want to say this to you too, Andrew, because I want you to look at these people and I want you to understand this. Small beginnings don't mean small endings. What you're doing here these last 2 nights, I feel anointed on this. What you're doing here is just a stepping stone. It's just, you just got to keep reaching and reaching. And I told you, I'll tell your dad too, I'll help you any way I can. Because I've been in this thing for a long time. Now, I'm not perfect. If you ask any of these people that know me, I'm not perfect. There's nobody perfect but Jesus. But one thing about it is, we got to pull in here, and I cannot stand and let my children not get ministered to when there's people willing to stand up and do it. Well, they're not going to listen to me or Sean or Bruce. I mean, they might listen to us as parents, but ministry, no. They need somebody their age that is called and ready to go. So you just remember that. This is just a small thing, but small things start. You've got to take that first step, and it's going to explode. So I'm looking forward to it, ain't you? I think we can do something great in the camp. I mean, you know, and really have some fun and see our teams. Hey, I just go down the road and put on 92.3 and just keep going. You know, at Lawrence County Station, that's all I listen to. That okay with. But, you know, everybody's got their own idea of what they want to do in church. Me, it's all about salvation. If it means coming in and preaching, or if it means coming in and singing, or if it means having a cookout or dinner, I don't care. Because it's all about getting people to heaven. Amen? Anybody got a testimony tonight or anything? Praise God. I'm going to pray. We got, I think, spaghetti back there. Come back. Just fellowship for a little bit. And get something to eat.